This is a very important day for us, in some sense, a historic day. Board today at its meeting at 5:15 has appointed Mr. K.V. Kamath as the chairman of the company.
I accept this position with deepest humility, because I think nobody can replace Murthy.
I look forward to working with K.V. and Shibu and taking Infosys to newer heights.
I have learned all the discipline which you talk about from you, commitment, leadership under you for the last 32 years. Thank you very much.
Thanks for joining us. It's a full house here at the Infosys campus. The top leadership team here is with us. Let me introduce you Ms. N.R. Narayanamurthy is the chairman emeritus of Infosys. K.V. Kamath is the newly appointed chairman of the company. Krish Gopalakrishnan is the executive co-chair. And Shibulal is the new chief executive officer of the company. Gentlemen, many thanks for joining us today. Mr. Murthy, I'll start with you. Would you categorize this leadership change as a significant turning point in the history of Infosys?
It is significant in one sense that I have been associated with this company for the last 30 years. I founded the company along with six other younger colleagues of mine. And I am stepping out. In that sense, for me, psychologically, emotionally, it is extremely significant. But for Infosys, as a company that aims to be in business for the next hundreds of years, it is not significant. Because we have got a wonderful new team. And therefore, it will continue to march on as successfully as it has done in the past. So personally, it is very, very significant. But for an organization, it has replaced one skin with another.
Mr. Kamath, we just spoke to Mr. Vagul, and he said Kamath has certain aggression and dynamism about him that he'll bring into Infosys. My question to you is, what will be the visible change that we will see in Infosys post this new leadership team coming into place?
The visible change has to be driven by the co-chair and the CEO, because that is their job. I think the role of the chair and the board is basically governance. As far as aggression goes, this is a company, I believe, is one of the most aggressive in the country in every context, right from tackling all the challenges over the last 32 years of its existence to currently looking at the environment and the challenges and positioning itself for the future. And as I say, you cannot look at aggression as a slice in time or a point in time. It is, I think, the culture, it is the history, it is the ability, and the context that we need to look at. And I think the company is very well positioned to drive its strategy, well thought out, and well envisioned into the future.
Chris, will the company be a lot more aggressive than before?
See, the company has always been aggressive and taking risk, you know, from saying from day one that we will be a global company, you know, first customer from the US. From day one, we have been aggressive. Even if you look at the last 4 years, we have gone from $3 billion to $6 billion in revenue. We have gone from about 79,000 employees to 130,000 employees. We have created a consulting group, which is today respected in the industry. We have changed even in the last 4 or 5 years. While the environment has been very, very challenging, we have made this change. We have honored all the offers given during the downturn. So you have to look at risk and aggression in all aspects. When we took the decision to honor 16,000 offers, where none of our competitors did that, that is a bold decision to take. So you have to look at it in the context of all the stakeholders of the company. And of course, we have been performing also very well. You know, we have gone from 3% growth to 26% growth this year. So we have demonstrated that we have growth, we have all the other aspects of aggression.
Shibu, what's going to be the strategy for growth? As Chris says, the operating environment has not been extremely conducive. It's been extremely challenging. Even then, as you take on as a chief executive, to your mind, what's the first thing?
So I clearly believe that the strategies we have put in place very recently with by Chris is extremely relevant for us. If you look at our client base, we see tremendous commonalities in what the clients are trying to achieve. They are trying to achieve growth, profitability, and differentiation. Our strategies are meant to enable them to create those. Our strategies are meant to enable us to operate in every facet of their business. So they are looking for efficiency in operations. We are able to do it. They are looking for transformation. We are able to do it. They are looking for business innovation. We are able to bring products and solutions to the market, which will allow them to operate in that space. Mm. So our strategy really takes us forward towards an enterprise player in the global system integration and consulting space. Mm. So I believe that the near term or the medium term priority will be to execute that. While we do that, we have to continue to increase our client relevancy. We have to continue to become global for the clients. Again, our clients are global clients. They expect us to be in South Africa and in Middle East and in Brazil. We need to be global in every part of the world. So the second important priority for us will be to increase our increase our client relevance continuously going forward.